Hi, this is Rolf from Tesla Owners US, and the third time is a charm because this is the third time I tried to install the battery for the trailer. And we tried the first time and we didn't have the right box for that to fit it in. Yeah. And then the second time, my trailer was stolen. And now it's the third time and we have everything ready. And we get a battery which has a power of 3 times as much. But we give you the details after the intro.
Hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun. Oh, we know what we have, let's hold on tight. Found what we're looking for in life.
Okay, here we are, and here is the big RV Omnu box for the 12-volt battery. And Sean explains a little bit about this battery and what is so special there.
Yeah, this is our Group 31 battery. It's our third generation battery, and we've been progressively bumping up our capacity every time because we believe that the largest capacity is always going to make best long-term performance. Not just for each time you use it, you're going to have more energy available, but over the long life of the battery, you're not going to tap into the extremes because you won't need to. You may not, with a bigger capacity, you may not have to fully charge to 100% and totally drain to 0% very often because you have a lot of extra battery there. And so that's just really good and healthy for the battery and subjects it to less stress. So the battery will last a really long time. It's a lithium iron phosphate chemistry, which of course is the best, and that'll give you really strong, solid performance even if you did go 100 to zero. And so you shed a lot of weight and you get much better performance and you get much longer lifespan out of this battery. Yeah. So those are the things we really believe in and we love about this battery.
And that's what we're gonna do. And we're gonna take that old lead acid battery in out there. It was staying in Canada outside for 2 years and it's probably done by now. It was really weak, I have to say. And I want to have a really good battery in there, and Sean supplies those battery, and then let's go and do that. Yeah, all right. So, installation. Open box party as of now. So here is the open box. I get him a box cutter. For terrorists, they are very attractive. Here are some screws and so on in, and then here is that huge piece of battery. Oh, it has even a huge strap. Look at that guy. Look at that guy. 12 volt, 156 amp hours, 2 kilowatt hours. 2 kilowatt hours capacity on that guy that will last for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you installed it in your own trailer as well?
Yeah, well, we have a Sprinter van.
You have a camping Sprinter van.
Yeah, this is what we've got running in there.
Yes. Yeah, okay, good. So, let's get in there and open that box. Yes. And here is that old sucker in there. And what is that capacity?
So the way they rate them, the best thing to look at would be right here. Reserve capacity of 120, which means when you're pulling 25 amps, it'll last 120 minutes, which is about 50 amp hours.
50 amp hours. So
it's lead acid amp hours also, which means you don't want to totally charge and discharge a lead acid battery. So you don't really have access to all 50.
Yeah. So does it do anything to the trailer right now? Yes.
It depends on what you have powered in there. My guess is
I have 120 volts as well.
Yeah, because you got a 120, so.
Yeah. So would that need to be still charged? Yes, right?
The new battery?
Yeah.
We typically ship them 50, 60% charged.
Oh, that's
so
good.
It'll have more energy than this battery fully charged already, but I mean, it's gonna need to get fully charged before you'll get max performance out of it.
So we lifted the new battery in there. And now we want to connect the red and the black. And
so on this trailer, they're using a white wire for negative,
Yes.
So the white's going to go to the black, and then a red.
A red for positive. Yeah, this is trailer standards. I noticed that recently.
Yeah, a little different usually.
Yeah, but trailer standards are different. Yeah. And then you move that over because I think the exit is here on this side,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. Okay.
This way's a
That is a nice battery. What I want to do is there is another barrier here in order that the battery does not slide within the box. And there are different spots here to lock it down. And that's what you want to do as well. We put the lid on it here, leave some room. And then after we put the lid on it, we put the stripe on it here as well. This sucker here, right?
Yeah.
Look at that, it looks good. Really striped down, locked down. It's fitting in there. Yes. That's what we need for a good camping weekend.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are done. We checked the battery on the voltage and it's all full, right? I think it's more, there's more energy in there what it should be. And we say thank you for Sean to do that installation for the battery. He sells these batteries as well,
yeah,
on his website, omnu.com,
yeah,
right? And recommend this battery, and I give you later one time an experience report how happy I am with this battery. All right, see you next time, and thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye.